Because it's fun.
Welcome to Musicalifornia. Behind me are the Rebel Pebbles, a new group that help illustrate how far women have come in rock. In the 30 years since an all-female group, the Chantels, first hit the U.S. charts, the all-girl sound has graduated from the sweet harmonies and ballads that were their trademark in the 50s to a sound that ranges from psychedelic to heavy metal. So today we'll show you L.A.'s latest crop of all-girl bands as we bring you the Screaming Sirens, the Pandoras, Precious Metal, Raszebrae, and this pop smash, the Bangles. Before we go into our special report on all-girl groups, let's turn the music news spotlight on rocker Dale Bosio, ex-leader of Missing Persons and now aspiring solo star. You may recognize this group, Missing Persons. They were part of an early 80s pop new wave movement and were particularly popular in Los Angeles. Their lead singer, Dale Bosio, was known for her squeaky high vocals and see-through plastic stage costumes. But Missing Persons only lasted until 1985. And now Dale is embarking on a new solo career.
Since then, I have put together a whole new concept for myself, professionally as a solo artist, and designed a whole new musical concept for myself. Somewhat pop, but pretty much R&B soul-based music. And I've written my album entitled Riot in English. The single now is Simon, which I had just finished a video for.
With a sound and look that combines unabashed eroticism and light funk, it seems natural that Dale would attract the attention of Prince and his Paisley Park label.
Prince, my very good friend. I was in a disco here in Los Angeles, a dance place, and we were walking this opposite ends of the hallway, and I tapped him on the nose and said, "Do you want to dance?" And he said, "Okay." So we danced. He asked me, "What are you doing with your career musically, and where is Missing Persons at?" So forth and so on. I said that we were probably going to disband soon, and I was looking forward to a solo career. He said, "Well, then make a demo, come and see me, let me hear it, and if it's right, we'll do some work." So he gave me some studio time, and I made the three first maybe singles of Riot in English. He said they were great. He signed me to Paisley Park, just like that.
In case you're wondering about the massive muscle co-starring in the video, it's Dale's husband, and he's had quite an influence on Dale's attitude toward life.
We filmed one day of the video at Gold's Gym here in Los Angeles, which is a famous muscle-building place. And so my husband Len, trained me as well for 4 months to make this video with all the muscles and a special diet. And this is something that he's been doing for 10 years. So I sort of looked at him and said, better get in shape. Is it real? Love you, baby blues. states, I think, to me, is that love is healthy, yes, and fit, and muscles, and I think that's something for the whole world to appreciate.
In the 50s and early 60s, all-girl bands came on the scene with their own special sound. Today, the tradition continues, but the sound has expanded and exploded. In the world of all-girl groups, it's the Bangles that currently lead the parade. Formed in Los Angeles in 1981, these women took vocal inspiration from classic 60s groups like the Byrds and the Mamas and the Papas. As they developed their sound, they found they filled a special niche in pop music. Now, 7 years, two LPs, and a number one single later, they told us their perspectives on women in music.
Look around, these are brown.
I mean, women have been doing music, dancing,
forever,
acting, the arts, painting. I mean, it's there's no reason why. I mean, when I grew up, I was listening to female singers in the 60s, and they were a big influence on me. So I don't think it's anything new.
What about the advantages of an all-female group?
I think, you know, the whole thing, the chemistry and everything works for four of us.
It is a little
more
comfortable.
It's like a bit of a girls' club sort of thing. We can share makeup or whatever. Yeah. Yeah. Little silly things like that, but
You could share makeup with,
and most
boys
most in a band
these days.
Point.
I say most boy bands wear more makeup than we do on stage.
The Bangles offered us an acoustic version of Let It Go from their second LP, A Different Light.
One thing or another.
World away from the polished, carefully harmonized sound of the Bangles is this group, the Screaming Sirens. Mixing country, punk, and rockabilly, the Sirens are out to make sure they and anyone listening are having fun. Like the Bangles, the Screaming Sirens have their reasons for taking an all-female format.
You know, I just thought it would be, you know, really a lot more fun, and it's easier to work with women, and there was never any band of women that were totally insane and wild ever before. I mean, you know, like, they were all, like, trying to be really tough or trying to be really feminine and giggly and girl groupy and stuff, and we just wanted to show that, you know, we can be just as wild and probably even sicker and crazier than any male group we know. In fact, we've scared some male groups we've played with. Like, some of them have, like, panicked when, oh my God, we're playing with the Sirens. I don't think we can play with you guys anymore. You're too crazy. And that's mainly from what happens offstage, though. We got them shaking in their boots.
Thank you.
Among the LA all-girl groups that have taken their cue from the Paisley days of the 60s is the Pandoras. Yet these women put their energy into what pop historians call the garage sound. Here, vocals are shouted, not just sung, guitars get fuzzy, and the overall effect is a tribute to an almost amateur rock sound.
We're on top of the Variety Arts Center, where we play live concerts all the time.
Every day.
And this is where we filmed Hungry for You.
Another all-girl group staking their claim on what used to be an exclusively male domain is Precious Metal. They categorize their sound this way.
Power pop. Metal gum.
Metal gum, fun rock, glitter glam.
Power pop.
Power pop, fun rock.
Do you like being labeled an all-girl band?
Sure.
Sure.
Yeah, we're girls, boys, as long as we're good, and we are good.
Show me that you want me. My love's been waiting for a real long time. My mother's not looking out the kitchen window. Come on, boy, I'll show you a good time. Say it's getting laid out. Stars just begun to shine. Say it's getting laid out. We'll have a real good time. Arrive find a place to park. Well, your mother gets worried after dark. Your favorite dinner she's planning to make. Well, Jay's house fares real good. Cheesecake. Say it's getting laid out. Stars just begun to shine. Say it's getting laid out. We'll have a real good time. It's a good thing. Last touch about the birds and the bees. The locker room top touch, you have to please. Say it's getting laid out. The stars just begun to shine. Say it's getting laid out. Oh, you'll change your mind. Say it's getting laid out. The stars just begun to shine. Now you say without a doubt. We'll have a real good time.
The final stop on our tour of L.A.'s all-girl groups is this foursome, Raszebrae. They're a band that contrasts with most all-girl groups in their lack of concern for trends. Instead, what they shun in image, they more than make up for in their sincere, almost tribal approach to rock and roll. For this edition of Musicalifornia, we'll see you next time when we bring you three bands that still inspire the raw energy of punk music. Among them, Black Flag. We'll let the Bangles tide you over till then.